Hello everyone, welcome to the video with me, Winner and Trades, picking up where we left last time, where I took over, that country right there, second one listed on that, took over that country which had basically all of this land here under their control, and also then went and also bought a war with this country right here, so I could get a little bit of land I needed over here that I needed so I could form the Russian Empire right here. One that actually stretches across all of Asia over here. So I got that and also got them as a vassal. So yeah, in this next episode I'm going to be focusing on taking over this little bit of land that I need, which will require me going to war with Mamluks here, which is the third strongest country in the world, and I think I'm going to need to recruit more troops to actually fight them, I think. So that is exactly what I'm going to do right now. Once I do that, I will have all the troops line up on their border here, and well, if they don't accept an ultimatum, I'll basically take a bunch of land over here. Just to make things a bit better, I guess. Probably gonna be cutting across right about here and taking everything else over here in the Middle East, around Turkey, and over here in Europe. So, they're basically gonna have everything from that point down left. So, yeah, I guess I need to get to work now. Not recruiting troops. So, now that I have my entire army there recruited, and which has now 20,000 troops for every single province that I have bordering them, basically meaning I'm nearly up to 400,000 troops now. Mainly built it up so much just to make sure I actually win this, and it's no problem to actually win, considering they are one of the strongest countries, and also the fact that my next target after them is basically the Ming, the second strongest country in the world. So it's going to be good to have an extra army right now, so I don't have to recruit more later, since I'm no doubt going to lose quite a few troops in this war by itself. But anyway, I need to send all these insults, so I can actually send an ultimatum. Start off with this, I'm only going to demand what I absolutely want from them over here. Which should be that right there, and I guess this here. Just to take care of this a little bit more. Okay. So 45 provinces and the liberation of that country. Okay. I need that though, except that'd be nice if they actually did. Since there'd be one less war I'd actually have to fight right now. So, let's go ahead and start this. There we go. Those troops going over there. And now, over here, to deal with this. And of course, their vassal is at war with me now as well. No surprise there. Split that army since I can attack that province. There we go. Now back over here to this. Let's get these two tiny countries to go to war with them. Just so it's less land I have to take. Now over here, I just can't take Istanbul. I'll keep those troops there, it's just keeping, just in case, because I'm pretty sure they're sending more over here. And that there might actually be a problem. 15,000 troops. Okay. I guess I'm sending some of these troops back then. To try and keep myself safe. Get a port built right there in that province, so I'm gonna try and get them over here quickly. Because those troops might actually be heading over here. Which will not be great for me. And I'll actually split this group as well. And send a little bit of it back. Okay. So, is there anything else I can do to cause a little bit more chaos against them? Could have a few of these countries go after them. I'll ignore it for right now. Oh, of course. They're coming in that way. Since they have military access there. Of course. Guess I'll have all those troops just stay back over here then. Since I have to deal with this. Okay. So. Yeah. Going quite well so far. Have that dealt with. So those troops right there don't actually have to go that direction or in defend, I guess. Guess I can also go and take these islands as well while I'm over here. There we go, dealt with that again. Now, I can finish things up here. Over here now. Nice. So, that's this area in Europe done, basically. And I now just need to finish this off over here. Well, at this point I do control everything I actually want to take, basically. But since I did get these two countries to go to war with them, I kind of realized that I kind of need to end the war completely. So they'll actually try and get a peace deal and take some of this land. So, yeah, I kind of had to take over their entire country because I decided to actually do that. So, I guess I have to push all the way through the rest of their country here. So I guess I can get them as a vassal at the end of this as well. Which would be nice to do. There aren't really any countries down there that I can have go to war with them, to be honest. Which is a bit annoying. Oh well, I guess I have to do it all by myself, instead of getting other countries involved at this point. this area basically sectioned off, so a small group can deal with it, while my main army just pushes south. Get a port built right there, so I can actually send troops over here into the Red Sea. Deal with the troops over here. Well, they have a few thousand troops defending their capital, of course. Slowly getting to the end of this now, thankfully. The rest of those troops are basically just going to stay up there since they're not going to be able to do anything at all for sure. Just too far behind to do anything. There we go. That site's done. Just need to go along the coast right there, and that'll be dealt with. Okay. So that'll basically just leave what's left over here. Get those troops grouped up there, and continue moving that army down there. I guess I'll have those troops attack right there, come in from the other direction. And now, I've completely wiped out their vassal. Okay, good. This is all they have left for now. So this shouldn't take too much longer until I have this war over. Oh, you're sending in more troops over here, huh? Too bad I have an army sitting right there. Basically ready to do it. Take out anything that starts heading in this direction. I managed to completely forget about that army right there. Great. Guess I'll send them back up. Okay. Oh, great. Of course one of those countries goes to war. The other two I literally don't care about, considering they're over in the middle of Europe. Mostly landlocked. Hamburg being the one that's not, because they actually have a little bit of land up there. Apparently some islands. Frankfurt, on the other hand, is completely landlocked. So, anyway, I guess I need to get troops sent over here to deal with this problem. Okay, good, all of them accepted peace. That's good. I guess I'll start letting these troops group up since this war is basically over now. They literally can't do anything to stop me. There we go. Now just let them get their peace deals over here. Okay, and who's that? Their other ally, which for some reason only just now went toward me. Great.
So I have 6 provinces over here that I need to try to take. Great. I just have this army here, conveniently, I just left behind. There we go. Now, peace deal. Let's get everything I want out of them. First. Okay. So, since I can't actually demand vassalization there, I wonder, what small countries over here could I possibly set up, maybe? Maybe Abnesia? Yeah, I think that would be quite nice, taking in that large chunk of their country out. Okay. There we go. Really, I don't even care about those last 3 points. Send those demands, and done. So, there we go. Before I go and do anything else, of course, I will first take over these 2. So I lost about 100,000 troops in that war by the looks of it. There we go. Good. So now I guess I'll just group up those troops right over here. Come down here. And move these troops up. Well, can I also send them there? Those troops I don't really care to move currently. So, now I just need to deal with province builds. Yay! So, got a province stability dealt with. Ottoman Empire and the Byzantine Empire decided to go to war with me. So I dealt with them nice and quickly. So, now that I have all of that dealt with, it is time to finish things off, I guess, over here for right now. Starting with this little country. It used to be one of the largest countries over here in the Middle East. And basically been reduced to nothing. So, here we go. Apparently have 4 vassals somewhere. Probably all have actually been wiped out. Not that I really care about any of them. But yeah, there we go. Selected all their provinces, and one of those vassals is actually still around over there. One of the countries I'll be going after in the future, I guess. Over here. There we go. Now, I'll take out this one as well. So, I think I will see about doing this as well, taking this little bit of land off of them now. Now, two countries have decided to go to war with me again. Of course. Still don't care about them. Especially the ones over here in Europe. There. So, next up, I will have this country go to war with this one. So they can take that single province from them. Meanwhile, I take the rest of their country. Okay, there we go. That is all that done now, I guess. So, yeah. Next up, the Ming. All the way over here. So I can take that little bit of land right there and what they have over here. And hopefully, at the same time, I'll be able to take the rest of what I need over here as well. And basically finish up what I need for the Russian Empire over here. And then just need to finish up over here in Europe, and I'm done. I can form the Russian Empire. So, yeah, that's pretty good, I guess. We have a nice group of vassals over here, I guess. Of course, not all of which actually like me. And really, I don't even need all this here, so I'll just put all the zeros in there, not getting mad at me over it, I guess. And they are also wanting independence soon, by the looks of it. Great. Try and improve relations with them all. Poland is trying to get independence as well. Annoyingly. So, I might actually have to take over Poland the next episode before they try to get independence. Great. But, yeah. Anyways, that there will be the end of this video. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye-bye!